If you're living with diabetes, you've probably been told that carbs are the enemy, that fruit is dangerous, that sugar is what raises your blood sugar. But here's the truth. The most dangerous food for diabetes isn't sugar at all. It's something hiding in almost every healthy meal plan that people with diabetes are told to eat. And today, I will show you exactly what it is, how it destroys insulin sensitivity, and what to eat instead, so you can finally bring your blood sugar down for good. Stick around, because the real culprit will surprise you. Most people think diabetes is just too much sugar in the blood. But the real problem is that your cells can't use that sugar properly. That's called insulin resistance. Think of your muscle and liver cells like tiny houses with locked doors. Glucose is standing outside, wanting to come in. Insulin is the key that unlocks the door. When everything's working, insulin knocks, the door opens, glucose walks in, and your blood sugar comes down. But when there's fat built up inside those cells, it's like someone stuffed chewing gum in the lock. The key doesn't churn, the door doesn't open, and glucose gets stuck outside in your bloodstream. So the question we actually need to ask is, what's gumming up the lock? Here's the twist. The number one most dangerous food for diabetes isn't sugar, it's fat. More specifically, saturated fat from meat, cheese, butter, and eggs, and refined oils like olive oil, coconut oil, avocado oil, vegetable oil. These foods are incredibly fat dense and don't have fiber. That fat doesn't just sit on your waistline. A lot of it gets stored as tiny fat droplets inside your muscle and liver cells where insulin is trying to work. The scientific term for this fat is intramyocellular and intrahepatocellular lipids. Those droplets are what block insulin from doing its job. So you might be eating very little carbohydrate, but as long as your cells are full of fat, your blood sugar can still stay high. Let's back this up with a little science, simple and clear. A large review in Nutrient Reviews looked at how different types of fatty acids affect insulin resistance. It concluded that the amount and type of fat you eat can significantly increase or decrease insulin resistance. In other words, high-fat diets, especially those rich in saturated fat, make it harder for insulin to work. And in a 16-week randomized clinical trial, adults were assigned to either a low-fat plant-based diet or no diet changes at all. The low-fat plant-based group lost more weight, reduced fat inside their liver and muscle cells, and significantly improved insulin sensitivity, all without counting calories or limiting carbs. This is the exact opposite of what most people with diabetes are told. They're told to cut carbs, but never told that fat is what's blocking insulin in the first place. So here's how the confusion starts. Someone with insulin resistance eats a banana. Their blood sugar spikes, and instantly they think carbs are the problem. I'm never touching those again. But let's look at what's really happening inside your body. Think of your metabolism like a kitchen sink. When the sink is clean, water flows freely through the drain. No problem at all. That water represents glucose, the fuel your cells need. The drain represents your cells, and insulin is the signal that lets that glucose move in. Now, what happens when the sink is clogged up with grease? The water can't drain properly. It backs up. But here's the question. Is the solution to never use that sink again? To say, well, water makes a mess, so I'll just stop using water. Of course not. The real solution is to unclog the drain, to find what's blocking the flow and clear it out. That's exactly what's happening with diabetes. The grease clogging your metabolic drain is fat inside your muscle and liver cells. Once you clear out that fat, glucose can finally flow in again. Your blood sugar drops naturally, not because you cut carbs, but because you fixed the clog. So when someone says, fruit spikes my blood sugar, what they're actually seeing isn't a carb problem. It's a fat problem. And the fix isn't avoiding fruit forever. It's cleaning the drain so your body can do what it's designed to do. So what's the number one most dangerous food for diabetes? Oil. Olive oil, coconut oil, avocado oil, canola oil, vegetable oil, doesn't matter which kind. They're all 100% fat, 0% fiber, extremely calorie dense, and they sneak their way into nearly every healthy meal. One tablespoon might not look like much, but it's 120 calories of pure liquid fat with no fiber, no water, and basically no nutrition. Think back to that clogged sink analogy. Oil is like the grease that slowly coats the inside of your metabolic drain. Each tablespoon makes the clog thicker and the flow slower until glucose can't move into your cells the way it's supposed to. So, if you've ever eaten a healthy salad with grilled chicken, cheese, and a creamy oil-based dressing, and your blood sugar still went up, it's not the lettuce that did it. It's the grease in the drain, the oil and animal fat that keep your body's metabolism clogged. And the good news? Once you start pulling the oil and saturated fat out of your diet, your body starts cleaning the pipes on its own. Glucose flows freely again, blood sugar stabilizes, and insulin sensitivity comes back. And in people already living with type 2 diabetes, randomized trials have shown that low-fat vegan diets improve glycemic control and cardiovascular risk factors more than a conventional diabetes diet. So when we say fat inside your cells causes insulin resistance, we're not guessing. We're simply explaining what these studies have been showing for years. So what do you do about it? You lower the fat and raise the fiber using whole plants. That means building your plate around fruits, mangoes, bananas, berries, apples, starches, potatoes, yams, squash, intact whole grains, legumes, beans, lentils, peas, vegetables, leafy greens, cruciferous veggies, colorful, non-starchy veggies. These foods are high in carbohydrates. Yes, on purpose. They're low in fat. They're packed with fiber and water and loaded with micronutrients that repair your metabolism. Over time, your body clears the fat out of your liver and muscles like a gentle internal detox. And when that fat clears out, guess what happens? Insulin works again. Blood sugar comes down. You can eat more carbohydrate with less medication. If you want to see exactly what these meals look like on a plate, comment guide below and we'll send you our favorite low-fat, nutrient-dense recipes that are designed specifically to reverse insulin resistance. Let's bring it all together. The real issue in diabetes is insulin resistance, not just too much sugar. Insulin resistance is caused largely by fat stored inside muscle and liver cells, especially from saturated fat and oils. That fat gums up the lock, so insulin can't open the door for glucose. So when you eat carbs, your blood sugar spikes. Not because carbs are evil, but because the door is stuck. The number one most dangerous food for diabetes is saturated fat, especially oil and high-fat animal foods, because they silently keep that door stuck all day long. A low-fat, plant-based, whole food diet has been shown to reduce fat inside cells, increase insulin sensitivity, and improve glycemic control in real people, in real clinical trials. So if you've been blaming bananas and potatoes, it might be time to look at the oil on your pan and the cheese on your plate instead. Your body isn't broken. It's just blocked. Remove the block and your metabolism can do exactly what it was designed to do. If you want help knowing what to eat to start clearing that fat out of your cells, comment guide below and we'll send you our free recipe guide packed with low-fat, plant-based, whole food meals to help you lower your blood sugar and reverse insulin resistance one meal at a time. If this video helped you, hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and share it with someone who's been terrified of carbs. Until next time, keep those carbs high and that A1C low.